What's up everyone, it's Kelly and today I've got another Swatch review for you. So today we're back for another installment of my Small Brand Sunday series, although you might have actually noticed it is not Sunday at the time of me uploading this video. I did recently change my schedule from uploading on Tuesdays, Fridays, and Sundays to Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, and one of my followers, Lainey, actually suggested because I'm not posting on Sunday anymore, I should call my Small Brand Sunday Small Brand Spotlight. So that is what we're going to be calling it now. So for today's Small Brand Spotlight, we are talking about a brand called Dame Nail Polish. I hope I'm pronouncing that right. The brand is spelled D-A-M, and I used to think it was Damn Nail Polish, but the pronunciation guide on the website says D-A-H-M is how you pronounce it. So hopefully I am pronouncing it correctly. It's actually named after the brand owner. It was her maiden name, now it's her middle name. But anyway, if you haven't heard of them before, they are an independent nail polish brand that is based in Virginia, and all of their polishes are 10-free, meaning they are free of 10 of the potentially harmful ingredients that can be found in nail polish. They are vegan, meaning they do not use any animal-derived ingredients, and they're also cruelty-free, meaning they do not test their products on animals. And I've been interested in this brand for a while. They specialize in these sort of special effects nail polishes, so the thermals, the intense shimmers, the reflective polishes, the magnetic polishes, the holos, that sort of thing. And let me tell you, their shades are incredibly unique. The more I go on with this series, the more I realize that there are so many brands that are just unlike any other I've tried, and the same could be said about this brand. So I have a bunch of polishes to try from you. It's not one specific collection, it's just a sampling of a bunch of their different formulas. So I'm going to swatch those for you, and then we're going to talk a little bit more about my thoughts on the brand in general, the pricing, the availability, all that good stuff. So let's roll the swatch footage. So as always with my swatch and review videos, I am using base coat underneath all of my swatches just to protect my natural nail and prevent any stains. Today it's the Orly Bonder base coat. So we'll start off with the linear hollow shades. This first one is called Data is My Love Language, and this one is a really soft periwinkle linear hollow, but it actually has a lot of other things going on in here. We have a duochrome shimmer that shifts from gold into green, and then it also looks like there are these bigger gold flecks running throughout. It's harder to see them individually, but I think they add a lot of extra sparkle as I move my nail around. And this is just such a stunning shade. It's one of those deceptively simple colors where it seems like it's just a plain linear hollow, but as you look at it, you can see all of these different elements coming together, and it's really gorgeous. This was my first try of the formula, and it was so smooth and creamy. Next, we have the shade Aquamarine, and this one is a gorgeous, vibrant blue linear hollow shade. And oh my goodness, at first swipe, I realized this is incredibly opaque. So as you can see, this actually ended up giving me one coat coverage on my nails. I would definitely wear this as a one coater. Now, keep in mind, I do have pretty short nails, so on longer nails, it might take more coats, but I think it was still a very impressive feat. And of course, I did do a second coat just to show you what that looked like, and it was so smooth and buttery of a formula, really so easy to work with. And here's what it looked like in that two coats. I always find that linear hollow polish looks its most holographic once the polish and the top coat are dry. So you always want to wait to see just how holographic it can be with that dry polish on your nails. Next up, we have the polish. Yep, it's yellow. And I don't know why this name made me cackle so much. It's so funny. So this one is another linear hollow, and this one is in a very vibrant golden yellow. And again, just a nice smooth formula. This one was a little bit less opaque, but I did get full coverage in two coats, and I was really impressed with it. I like that there's seemingly a mix of slightly larger and smaller hollow particles in here, because I find that these holographic polishes are pretty multifaceted. So you can see as I'm wiggling my nail around, there are some little specks that catch the light a little bit differently. So I thought that was really gorgeous. I'm not sure if that's exactly the case, but that's what it looked like on the nails, and I was impressed. Next, we have the shade A Whimsical Dream, and I live for polishes like this, ones that are intentionally sheer but have this really intense shimmer. And this one has this super soft sheer pink base, and then it has this very intense, rich cobalt blue shimmer running throughout. I thought this was gorgeous in one coat, but I also thought it was very pretty in two. It kind of softened my visible nail line without covering it up completely, and I know on camera it looks like it's maybe a little streaky, but I don't think that's the case. I think it's really just so shimmery and reflective that the parts where it looks like it's streaky is actually just reflections of darker things. So in person, absolutely stunning. Moving on, we have the shade Sunset Blues, and if you know me, you probably already know that just seeing this one in the bottle was such a thrill for me, because this is basically my favorite type of nail polish, a very cool toned purple. This one actually is a royal blue jelly-like base, and then it has this intense fuchsia shimmer in there, and it just makes such a beautiful contrast. Now, this base color is a little bit more sheer, and I was so certain that I was going to take three coats for full coverage, but it ended up actually giving me full coverage in two coats, which I thought was so impressive, and it really looks like this lit from within gorgeousness. I love that strong contrast between this fuchsia color and this intense blue, and I love that jelly-like look to it. Then we have the shade Jingle Berries, and this one is a very similar type of formula. So we have this jelly-like base, and in this case, it's more of a reddish pink color, and then within that, we have a really intense shimmer, and head-on, that shimmer looks mostly red, but around the edges, you actually see orange into gold, and there's also a light scattering of larger flecks in here. Again, just catching the light so beautifully. And this was another one that I just loved the way that it looked in two coats, because I feel like it was just the perfect mix of that pinky purpley base color and that intense reddish orange shimmer. But I was curious to see what it looked like in three coats, and I am so glad I did, because it is stunning in three coats. I think it just makes the color so much more deep and rich. So I think kind of just depending on my mood, I would probably wear it in two or three coats. In two coats, it felt like more of a vibrant spring summer kind of shade, and in three coats, it feels like more of a winter shade. Then we have a shade that you probably spotted in some previous videos of mine. This is Crying Right Now, and this one is such a party on the nails. Oh my gosh. It's actually a multichrome that has a reflective gold shimmer running throughout. So you can see there's actually a lot of colors going on in here. Mostly I see green and blue, but it also shifts into purple and even pink. And let me tell you, my camera does not do this one justice. I'm going to show you what it looks like on my phone with flash, just so you can see that reflective pigment. But if you really want to see what it looks like, I did do a recent short here on YouTube where I did my manicures of the week, and I wore this as a full manicure, and I showed it in a few different lighting situations, and it is absolutely stunning. So definitely check that out. Now we have the shade Poison Farts, which is definitely going on my list of one of the more bizarre names of polishes that I have. And this one is a similar reflective polish. This one is a really intense blue. And I think this is also that multichrome vibe, but it is a little bit less intense. So it mostly looks blue and indigo into purple. But then we also have a reflective holographic sparkle and also a soft seafoamy green reflective sparkle in there. So with my phone flash, it just looked super interesting with that contrast of the intense blue and that soft greenish reflective. Just so cool. Then we have two more reflective shimmers that were very similar vibes but different colors. This first one is called Have Fun, Be Weird, and this one was really interesting. It's almost like this white multichrome vibe where you can see so many colors within the base, but mostly it looks green into gold, but around the edges you can see a little bit of blue and into purple. And then we have this intense white reflective shimmer and a hollow sparkle running throughout. And I love the slight sheerness of this one. I actually loved the way that it looked in one coat, but I feel like I got the perfect coverage in two coats where you could just get a lot of depth of color, but you still got that slight touch of visible nail line in there. And of course, my camera does not do this one justice. The reflective shimmer is so cool. And then we have the shade Love Lots, which is very similar to Have Fun and Be Weird, but where Have Fun Be Weird was more of a greenish color, this one is that intense cobalt blue again. So this one looks mostly blue head on, but it shifts into indigo and into purple, and then even into a little bit of pink at more extreme angles. And again, we have that hollow sparkle as well as that intense white reflective pigment in there that just makes it look so cool. And again, I loved the way that it looked in one coat, but I also love the way that it looked in two coats. And I just thought it was a really interesting contrast with that white reflective shimmer and that blue base shimmer. It just looked very cool. It felt very ethereal and magical. Moving on, we have the shade Serious Slumber, and this one's actually unlike anything in my collection. The bottle is a little bit deceptive because some of the larger glitters sunk to the bottom, but it didn't affect the way that it applied on the nail. But this one is a jelly that has this soft pink glitter and white reflective shimmer, but then we also have small and medium white hex glitters running throughout, and they have a more matte satiny kind of finish. And I just thought this was so cool. I've really not seen a reflective polish that has bigger glitters in it, but I think it just adds so much texture and fun. So I definitely enjoyed that. Next, we have the shade Not Feelin' It, which is an ironic name because truly I was feeling this polish. It is a multichrome, and looking at it head on, it looks mostly pink into gold, but then around the edges, you can see green and blue and even into purple, and then back to that pink color again. And what I thought was really impressive about this one is that it did give me two coat coverage. Now, I do find that multichrome polishes can be hit or miss. Sometimes they are super sheer, but that is not the case with this one. It is just so impressive, and it was so buttery smooth and easy to apply and just so stunning on. The final two polishes I want to share with you are Magnetic Multichromes, and wait until you see them because my mind was absolutely blown. This first one was called Alternate Adventure, and this one is a multichrome base that shifts from green into blue into purple and even into pink, and then we have a golden magnetic pigment running throughout. So the way I like to do magnetic manicures is I will do my manicure full coverage. In this case, it was two coats, and then I will do one final coat, and while that's still wet, I will magnetize it. In this case, I am doing the cat eye magnet, which is basically me just hovering the magnet diagonally over my nails, and I feel like that gives a kind of spacey look, which is perfect for these polishes because they are very spacey looking. And when I pulled the magnet away from this polish, I gasped. I was not expecting this. The way that all of that golden pigment just focused in the center like a gorgeous nebula, and then you could see the colors of the multichrome around it, was just unreal gorgeous. I couldn't get enough of it. And then we have the shade Quantum Quest, and this one is another multichrome magnetic. And again, I was very excited for this one, especially just based on how it looked in the bottle. But these are another set of polishes that are just so deceptive because when you apply them normally, they just seem like regular metallic sort of multichrome polishes. But once you pull all of that magnetic pigment out of there, it just looks so different and cool. So this one has a mostly blue multichrome base, but it shifts into purple and into pink and even into orange. And then we have that magnetic pigment that is on the pink side. And then when you pull that away, it almost looked like it was purple before I magnetized it. But once I did, I got all of that pinky color right into the center and all of that intense blue surrounding it. Again, it just felt so cosmic and stunning and really unlike any other magnetic polish I own. So I was just blown away by this. For these two polishes alone, I am immediately in love with this brand. So here are all of the polishes together. Like I said, this isn't one collection. This is just a sampling of what the brand has to offer. And just from this, I am so impressed with them. I am so enamored by their color combinations and all of the different types of polishes that they not only do, but do incredibly well and do in a very unique way. So I was especially impressed with the reflective polishes, which I honestly love reflective polishes. I know not everybody does, but I feel like especially when you're working with more unique color combinations, it just makes them that much more special. And then I also, of course, loved those multichrome magnetics. They are unlike anything else I own, and I thought they were just so special and gorgeous, and I can't wait to wear them as a full manicure and just play around with them because they're just stunning. So yeah, let's talk a little bit more about them. So those are the polishes, and like I said, this isn't one specific collection. It's just a sampling of a bunch of different polishes from them, and I have to say, I am incredibly incredibly impressed. I think the formulas are just so smooth and workable. I think the colors themselves are really unlike anything I've tried, and they seem to have a really good handle on the pigmentation, the opacity, all of that stuff that just makes a polish good quality, but they also have these really unique shades. So I think it's a very beginner-friendly brand. If you don't like those intermediate formulas, but you still want something a little funky and unique, I think this is the perfect brand for that. Honestly, I feel like my videos didn't even do a lot of these polishes justice because they're just so stunning in person, especially the more reflective shades. I think you really need to actually see them in person to be able to appreciate what they're made of because there's just so much going on in there. So these polishes come in 15 milliliter bottles. They have a wide flat brush that has a rounded tip, so application is really easy. I definitely didn't have any difficulty applying these just between that really easy formula and that really nice brush. So definitely very easy to work with. I also want to take a quick second to appreciate their packaging because I think it's adorable. They just have these little white and blue boxes that have little holographic hearts on the side, and they also have a little heart-shaped cutout where you can see the polish through it, which I think is so cute. Yeah, definitely appreciate little things like this when it comes to brands, especially independent brands. It's more expensive to really put those extra special touches into your brand, so whenever I see it, I'm always very appreciative of that. The price does vary based on the type of formula that you're getting, but they seem to range between $12 and $13 USD on the Dom Polish website. I did see that they offer free shipping for orders over $75 USD, and they also offer a 10% discount code if you sign up for their mailing list. So I'm going to put all of that info down in the description. You can check that out if you're interested, but I would love to hear from you. What do you think of Dom nail polish? Am I pronouncing it right? But also, which shade is your favorite from them if you have tried them? If you haven't tried them, which shade piques your curiosity? Definitely let me know in the comments. I know a lot of you like this brand because a lot of you are excited to see them on my nails in my recent videos. So I'm definitely eager to hear from you guys. If you enjoy my small brand spotlight, please give this video a thumbs up. It lets me know I'm doing a good job. And if you're not already subscribed to my channel, please consider subscribing. My new schedule is I post on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays. I also have a second YouTube channel, my vlog channel, and that's pretty much where I post stuff that is not nail polish related, just my everyday life outside of these reviews. So if you're interested in that, I'll link it up in the cards. And of course, a huge shout out to my supporters on Patreon, my Royal Astronomer Amanda M, as well as my Cosmic Admirals, Rocket Man's Daughter, Paola, Ken, Rosie, and Courtney. I really appreciate your support, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye. Today's fun fact question comes from Patreon supporter Megan D, and Megan D wants to know, do your family and friends get you nail things anymore, or do they just assume you already have everything? I think there is a point of total saturation. I remember for the first several years I was doing this, everyone was getting me nail polish, but now we're at the point where I'm getting everybody else nail polish things. I do get sent a lot of products in PR. I actually turn down, honestly, I want to say the majority of the PR that I'm offered, just because I have so many nail polishes, I'm never going to be able to use all of them up in my lifetime. I do regularly donate the polishes to different shelters and organizations that accept them, but I also do give away a lot of my nail polishes to friends and family. Yeah, I feel like there was a point when I first started getting into nail polish, it was such an easy gift that everybody knew they could always just get me nail polish or nail art accessories or anything like that. And I always very much appreciated that. I would say every once in a while, someone still gifts me something. And it's funny because I feel like whenever somebody does gift me a nail polish product, it's always something that I don't have, which is crazy considering how much I have. But yeah, I would say in general, most people don't get me nail polish stuff anymore just because, like I said, I already have so much of it. But even if they do, and even if on the off chance somebody gave me something that I already had, I feel like I'm always just so appreciative in general of gifts. But I do definitely love giving nail polish gifts, especially in the case of like a friend or family member who watches a lot of my reviews is like gushing over a color or finish. I love to give it to them. And it definitely feels very good to be able to do that. I'm curious though, for the rest of you nail polish collectors, do you receive nail polish products as gifts, or do you prefer to get it for yourself? Let me know in the comments. We can chat about it, and I will see you all in my next video. Bye.